Enjoy your pizza.
Platform I work on. I peel the garlic and cut the cheeses up.
Did you say
and prepare
cut the cheese?
And cut the cheese.
This is the pot that we're going to be using for the sauce, which we will show you in a second.
And this is the sauce you got to use, the San Marzano. San Marzano. You can either get the chopped or the whole. I prefer the whole, but this is like a dollar a can cheaper. But and it's the same thing. I just don't chop it. So when I get the plum ones, I chop it. So it gets just like this. So why spend the extra dollar?
Exactly.
But if they were the same price, I'd get it just to say I chopped it myself. Two sauces. We're making two pizzas, plus I'll have leftover sauce for either soup or for another type of dish we need sauce for, maybe some macaroni or something. That's one. And we got two sauces. We're making two pizzas, plus I'll have leftover sauce for either soup or for another type of dish we need sauce for, maybe some macaroni or something. Get our ingredients ready. Seasoning.
Italian seasoning.
Pour that.
Tear the basil.
Don't chop it. Ingredients in there, all our seasonings. Now we got to put some of this in, which is some light brown sugar. Get about a good hefty tablespoon. Oh, we got two cans there. I got to get a little bit more. Butter. About 2 tablespoons. And we add that right at the end. Right now the wine is getting room temperature, and so is the butter. There she goes. Slice, like that.
So you brought them pre-sliced? You buy them pre-sliced and cut in quarters.
Sometimes a little, some bigger, some smaller. Some quarters. Got all the mozzarella cut up in nice little pieces so I can sprinkle all around. This is a fresh mozzarella. Fresh. Oh, that's provolone. This is our provolone. We're gonna grade this here fresh. Not too much, because it's very strong, this cheese. You know, only put a little bit on each pie.
I'm so excited.
I'm gonna put the butter and wine in here. And keep it on very low for about 5 minutes longer. And then you keep it on the side. Let it get cool to put on top of the pizza.
How excited are you for this pizza?
Three hours later. Mm-hmm.
shake the water out. Water equals flop.
Where do you get one of these? So
happy right now. In the kitchen store.
How I built, construct a pizza, go onto one of the previous sites, and you can see the original. This is just another set of pies that we keep testing and hoping to get perfection. Testing for perfection. Right there, what are my customers are thinking?
I'm going for the scent right now. I can smell it with something baking in the oven. Smell it?
Yep.
I can't wait.
I don't know yet, because I've never had Grandpa's pizza. It looks a bit saucy, a bit acidic, too much cheese.
So you're a little hesitant is what I'm hearing.
Yeah, hesitant.
Okay. Well, we'll come back when
I'll have to see how it tastes.
Are you going
to
try it?
Yeah, I'm going to try it.
Oh, word taken on. He's going to try it. I personally have watched this pizza go through patches. I've watched this pizza go through everything, and I am so excited to see how he recovered from the patch, honestly. I'm ready for it.
The taste was delicious. A little floppy. We like it a little crusty. No flop. But it was fine. It was very tasty. Compliments to the pizza man, always.
Chef Joe Pergola.
Chef Joe Pergola.
I was patient. I did let it cool off. I think that gave it a higher score for me, and flavor was absolutely there. Sauce, 10 out of 10. I'd give it a 8.8. Okay, so the pizza was good overall. Had a little flop, but I think I'd give an 8.5 because the flavor was there. Good flavor.
The roof of my mouth is singed. It's burned. It's raw. I can't even put my tongue on it. I ate that first piece so hot I couldn't believe it. It was good, but the flop stuck to the roof of my mouth. Never happened before.